The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, first chapter, text number 21 and 22, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on July 18, 1973, in London, England.
Translation: Arjuna said, O infallible one, please draw my chariot between the two armies, so that I may see who is present here, who is desirous of fighting, and with whom I must contend in this great battle attempt.
Senaya ruvayar madde ratam sthapayo me achyuto. Before this, Krishna was addressed as Rishikesha. Rishikesha, we have explained. Now, Krishna is addressed here, Achyuta. Chyuta means fallen. And Achyuta means not fallen. Just like we are fallen. We are fallen conditioned souls. In this material world, we have come with an enjoying spirit. Therefore, we are fallen. If one keeps his position rightly, he does not fall. Otherwise, he is degraded, that is fallen condition. So, all the living entities within this material world, beginning from Brahma down to this small, insignificant ant, they are all fallen, fallen conditioned souls. Why they are fallen? Krishna bhulya jeev bhogobancha kare pasete maya tare japotiya dhare. Fallen means when the living entities are under the clutches of this material energy. That is called fallen. Just like a man, when he is under police custody, it is to be understood that he is a criminal. He is fallen. He has fallen down from good citizenship. Similarly, we are all parts and parcels of Krishna. Mamaimamsa jiva bhuta. So, as part and parcel, our position is to live with Krishna. Just like this is my finger, part and parcel of my body. The finger must remain attached with this body. When this finger is cut off and fallen, although it is finger, it is no longer as important as it was formerly when it was attached with this body. So, anyone who is not attached with the service of the Supreme Lord, he is fallen. This is the conclusion. But Krishna is not fallen. He Krishna, because he comes to reclaim us, yada yada hi dharma saglani bhavati bharat, abhuttanam adharmas tadatmanam sijami aham. Krishna says, I appear when there is discrepancies in the I mean to say, occupational duties of the living entities. Dharmasya glani bhavati. We don't translate dharma as religion. Religion, in the English dictionary, it is a kind of faith. Faith can be changed. But dharma is a word which cannot be changed. If it is changed, it is to be understood artificial. Just as the water. Water is liquid, everyone knows. But sometimes water becomes hard, very hard. Ice. That is not the natural position of water. Artificially, on account of excessive cold, or by artificial means, the water becomes solid. But the real position of water is liquidity. So, when we are detached from the service of the Lord, this is also unnatural. Unnatural. Natural position is that we must be engaged in the service of the Lord. That is our natural position. Therefore, the Vaishnava Kavi says that Krishna Bhulya Jeev Bhogavansha Kare. When a living entity forgets Krishna, forgets Krishna's position. Krishna's position, Krishna says, Bhoktaram Jagatapasam, Sarvaloka Maheswaram. I am the proprietor, I am the enjoyer. This is the Krishna's position. He never falls down that position. Krishna is the enjoyer. He keeps always that position. He never falls down. He never comes to the position of being enjoyed. That is not possible. If you want to bring Krishna on the position of being enjoyed, then you are defeated. Being enjoyed means keeping Krishna in front, I want to get some profit of sense gratification. That is our unnatural position. Krishna will never agree. Krishna will never agree. Krishna cannot be enjoyed. He is always enjoyed. He is always the proprietor. So Krishna Bhulya Jeev means when we forget this position of Krishna, that He is the supreme enjoyer, He is the supreme proprietor. This is called forgetfulness. As soon as I think that I am enjoyer, I am proprietor, this is my fallen stage. Krishna Bhulya Jeev Bhogavansha Kare. When we, they are Japutiya Dhare, Maya, immediately Maya captures. Therefore, a conditioned soul, fallen conditioned soul, is struggling for existence. He is trying to be enjoyer, he is trying to be proprietor. That is his artificial way of life. Just like if a woman wants to become a man, that is her artificial position. She may dress herself as a man, just like in the Western countries sometimes we see a woman is artificially dressing like man, with hat, coat, pant, riding on horse. That is artificial. So similarly, our position here in this material world is artificial. We are trying to imitate a man. Actually, the living entities are described in the Bhagavad Gita, Prakriti. Prakriti means woman, and Purush means man. So, the living entities are never described as Purusha. Purusha is Krishna. Purusha Shasata. When Arjuna said, Parabrahma Param Dhamma Pavittam Paramam Bhavan Purusham Shasatam Adyam. Purusham Shasatam. Krishna is always Purusha. God cannot be female. God is always male, Purusha. And we are Prakriti. That is described in the Bhagavad Gita. Aparayam itastu vidhimi prakritim para. After describing the material energy, bhumi rapanalu vayu, earth, water, air, fire, this material, this is also female, prakriti. Female means we have got, in India, we have got little experience. The female is always controlled. Female is never given the position of controller. Nowadays it is going on. Just like Indira Gandhi, he has given the position of controller. This is artificial. In the history of India, Greater India, Mahabharata, you'll never find that a woman has been given the position of controller. No. It is not possible. We have to take things from the Shastra. In the Bhagavad Gita also, woman's position has been equated with Sudra. Sriya Shudra Tatha Vaishya Sti Vijanti Parangati. So, position must be asserted. But this position is artificial. Here, either woman or man, they are in artificial position. Because a woman may be in woman's dress, but her mind is like man. She also wants to enjoy. And the others, the so-called man, is also not man, she is woman. Prakriti. Aparayam itastu vidhi me prakritim para. Prakriti. As the earth, water, air, fire, sky, they are also controlled. The supreme controller is Krishna. Similarly, the so-called man or woman in this material, they are also controlled. Nobody can say that I am not controlled. Who is here? He must be controlled. Therefore we see two prakritis, para-prakriti and apara-prakriti. But all of them are controlled. None of them are the controller. And that is the difference between purusha and prakriti. Purusha means controller. And prakriti means control. Purusha means predominator. And prakriti means predominated. This is the difference. So Krishna does not fall from his position of predominator. Therefore he is addressed as Achyuta. Achyuta. Sinaya Ruhaya Madhye Rathasthapaya Me Achyuta. Another meaning of Achyuta, Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and Arjuna knows that I am not controller, I am controlled. He is devotee, he knows his position. Therefore, he is now trying to control Krishna. He is ordering Krishna. Senaya Rubhar Madhye Ratam Sthapaya. My dear Krishna, he is not addressing as Krishna, Uchyuta. Now you place my chariot between the two parties. This is ordering. That means Arjuna becoming controller and Krishna becoming control. Just the opposite. Therefore, Arjuna knows his subordinate position and he is ordering to Krishna, so indirectly he is begging to be excused. My dear Krishna, I cannot order it. Order must come from you. But because you promised to carry out my order, you wanted to become my chariot driver, therefore I am ordering. I'm not in position of ordering to you, and you promise to carry out my order, and I think you are fixed up in your that promise, therefore I am asking you, Achyuta. You don't fall from your promise. This is it. Senaya Rubhaya Madhye Ratham Sthapaya Me Achyuta. What is the number of verse? The next point is that Arjuna wanted to see with whom he had to fight. He had no desire to fight. That will be explained. He was fighting unwillingly. Unwillingly. Because he is a Vaishnava. Unnecessarily, he does not want to kill. Although he is Kshatriya, it is his duty. Whenever there is discrepancy, killing as representative of Krishna. Krishna has got two business. Paritranaya sadhana vinashaya cha duskita. He has got two businesses. One business is to give protection to the devotees, sadhu. Sadhu. Sadhu means devotee. Sadhu does not mean simply by changing dress, saffron collar and smoking bidi. That is not sadhu. Sadhu means devotee. One who is devotee, that is explained in many shastras. Sadhava sadhu bhujana. Sadhu bhujana. Titikshava karunika. Suridam sarva bhutana. Ajado sattva shanta. Sadhava sadhu bhujana. This is the qualification of sadhu. Sadhu is titikshava, tolerates all kinds of miserable conditions. He is sadhu. Because this is a place of miserable condition. A sadhu learns how to tolerate. Sadhu is never disturbed. Jasmin sthite guru napi dukkhena no vichalati. sadhu who has got the shelter of Krishna, if he is placed in the severest type of dangerous condition, he is never disturbed. Just like Prahlad Maharaj, his father was putting him in so many dangerous conditions. Even he was supplied with poison. He knew that my father has given me poison to drink. All right, let me. If Krishna likes, he'll send me. I am now put into this dangerous position, I have to drink. A father is giving poison, who can check? And such a big, powerful Hiranyakashipu, the mother cried, requested, he forced the mother, Prahlad's mother, give your son this poison. So she begged so much, but he was a rascal demon, he must be. So the mother knew, the son knew that the rascal father is giving this poison. What can he do? Small child, all right, let me drink. Guru Navi Dukhena Navi Chala. He's not hesitating. All right, if Krishna likes, I like. This is the position of sadhu. He is not disturbed. Titik Sabha. In all circumstances, he is tolerant. That is sadhu. Sadhu does not become disturbed. Titik Sabha. At the same time, Karunika. He is himself disturbed, but he is merciful to others. Just like Jesus Christ. He is being crucified, and he is still his merciful. God, these people do not know what they are doing. Please excuse me. This is how. He is personally being disturbed by the demons. But still, he is merciful to the general people. They are suffering for want of Krishna consciousness. So, even up to the point of death, he is trying to preach Krishna consciousness. Let the people be benefited. What is this material body? Even if I am killed, I am not killed. This body is killed. That's all. This is sadhu. Titiksava karunika. In one side he is tolerant and other side merciful. The material world, when one man is disturbed, he cannot do any beneficial work to any others. He is disturbed. I am very much disturbed. Don't talk with me. No, but sadhu still goes on benefiting the people in the earth. Titiksava karunika. And what kind of benefit? The so-called rascals' humanitarian work? No. Sridhang sarva-bhutanam. He is beneficial to all kinds of living entities. Not this rascal land. Daridra Narayan. Just like one rascal has manufactured this. Daridra Narayan. The poor man has become Narayan, and the goat Narayan is killed for their feeding. Not this kind of sadhu. Sridhang sarva-bhutanam. A sadhu will not allow any kind of killing. See, in the Christian religion, it is first injunction is, thou shalt not kill. If you want to become religious, they are simply killing. And still they are claiming Christian. What kind of Christian? Simply their business is killing. So it is very difficult to find out a Christian, although they are claiming I am Christian. It is very difficult. Because their business is killing. And Lord Jesus Christ ordered, first order is, thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not covet. Who is calling? Sadhu is Sridhang sarva-bhutanam. why he should allow animal killing. They are also living entities. But for their benefit, the so-called sadhu says the animal has no soul. What is this nonsense? Animal has no soul? Why? Why animal and what is the difference between animal and man? What are the symptoms of possessing the soul? They are all equal. The man also eats, the animal also eats. The man also sleeps, the animal also sleeps. The man also has sex life, the animal also has sex life. The man also defends, the animal also defends. So where is the deficiency that you say the animal has no soul? Imperfect knowledge or making adjustment for their own benefit. Now they are making correction. Thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not murder. That means it will come to human being. But the actual commandment is thou shalt not kill. But these Christian people, they are making some amendment. Thou shalt not murder. Because murder will apply to the killing of human being. But Lord Jesus Christ never said like that. Thou shalt not kill. It is applicable both for human being and for animal, or even for trees. Unnecessarily cannot kill. That is sadhu. Sridham sarvabhutana. Don't kill my brother, but you can kill my neighbor. Not like that. He's not sadhu. Sadhu is kind to all living entities. Krishna consciousness means to become kind to everyone. Therefore we say, no meat eating. Meat eating means killing the animals. Killing the animals. Why you shall kill animals? You have to take Krishna prasadam. Patram puspam phalam toyam jumi bhakta prajacchati tadaham asnami. Krishna says, Krishna is God. He can eat everything. Everything. Krishna ate fire, you know. There was forest fire in Vrindavan. All the cowherds, boys, they become very much frightened. Krishna, yes, I am ready. He ate up all the fire. So for Krishna, he could eat anything he likes. He is God. But still he recommends, patram puspam phalam tuyam, jumi bhaktya prajitcha. Why? Because we have to take Krishna's prasadam. So therefore, he is recommending these things you can give me. Patram puspam phalam tuyam. So that is our food. We as devotees of Krishna, we are meant for eating the remnants of foodstuff offered to Krishna. That is all. Jiva Taramandeja, if you want to conquer the tongue, then you fix up your mind that you shall not take anything which is not offered to Krishna. Then your tongue will be controlled. Tarmadde jivhavati lobhamaya sudurmati. Tongue is the bitterest enemy of the living being. The tongue is dragging jivha. Kindly give me this immediately. Kindly give me this wine immediately. Kindly give me this tea immediately. Kindly give me this cigarette immediately. Kindly give me this meat. Why? Control. Krishna says, patram pusmam phalam tayam. So you have to take prasadam, eat Krishna prasadam. Then naturally, the other things will be negative. This is the position. Sridham sarvabhutana. So, if all human beings becomes vegetarian, not vegetarian, but eater of the Krishna's prasadam, all these liquor house and slaughter house and brothels will be closed. This is Krishna consciousness. We want to close this nonsense. places of sinful life. Brothers, illegitimate sense gratification, sex relationship, prostitution. If we are embarrassed with this sinful life, there is no possibility of becoming again achyuto. We remain chuto, fallen. We remain fallen. It is not so easy thing that I do everything, whatever I like. Some rascals preach that, oh yeah, religion has nothing to do with your eating. You can eat anything you like, and still you become a religious man. It's all nonsense. Nobody can become a religious man if he is attracted by sinful activities. That is not possible. You must stop sinful activities. That is first condition. Otherwise you cannot understand what they... People, in this Krishna consciousness, except this Krishna consciousness, all the rascals, they do not know what is God. They have no clear conception of God because they are sinful. We can give the name, address and everything of God. Clear conception, not vague idea. God may be like this, God may be like that. Why maybe? Here is God. Venum kannantam aravindadalayatasam varahavatam samasitam buddhasundaram kannatpa koti kavaniya visesha sobham govindam adipurusam tamaham bhajami. Clear concept. The Shastra, Brahma Sanghita, clear description of God. Venum kannantam. He is playing on flute. It is not that the Muralidha, Shyamasundara, Krishna has been imagined by some poet. No. It is described in the Shastra, the form of the Lord. He is busy in playing flute. Venum kannantam. Aravinda dalayataksam, his eyes are just like petals of the lotus flower. Venam kannantam aravinda varahavatam sa, there is a peacock feather on his head. Kandatpa koti kamaniya visesa sobham, and he is so beautiful that his beauty can cut down thousands of cupid. Cupid is supposed to be the most beautiful in this material world. Kandatpa koti kamaniya visesa sobham govindam adipurusam tamam maya. Clear concept. This is the description of God in the Shastra. And when God came, Krishna came on this planet, the same description. He is playing on flute. He has got the feather, peacock feather. So this painting of Krishna is not an artist's imagination. It is exactly the form. So here is the form of the Lord. Here is the name of the Lord. Here is the activities of the Lord. This is clear conception. The sadhu knows what is God. Or sadhu cannot know. They are thinking, God must be like this, God must be maybe like this. He must be a very old man, because Adipurusam is the first living in this earth. So you cannot create God by imagination. That is not possible. God is God. Always. We have to know simply what is God. He is never a chuta. God never becomes fallen down from his original position. The original position is God described himself, matta parataram nana. There is no more superior authority than me. That is God. One, if he is controlled, how can be God? God. The supreme controller is God. The supreme controller is Krishna. Ishara Parama Krishna. Ishara means control. And Parama means supreme. And who is that? Krishna. Krishna says also, Matta Paratanam Nanya. Kinchija Sridhananjaya. So he is Achyuta. He keeps his position. He never falls down. We are all fallen souls. Because our position, our Achyuta position is ki to serve Krishna. Because we are part and parcel of Krishna. The same example, just like this finger is part and parcel of my body. Its business is to serve the body. That is the business. There is no other business. A finger can pick up a rasagulla and keep it here. The finger cannot eat. Similarly, we cannot eat directly. That is our disease condition. We have to offer Krishna. When Krishna eats, if we eat that, then we become energized. Just like you rasagulla put into the mouth, when it goes to the stomach, the finger immediately becomes ready. The finger enjoys. Not only the finger, the eyes enjoy, the leg enjoy, because the energy is distributed. Directly, we cannot be energized by eating. We must eat Krishna's prasad. This is principle. Jive sarupha nitya Krishna das. So if we serve Krishna, that is our achyuta position. If you deny to serve Krishna, that is bichyuta, fallen condition. Achyuta and bichyuta. So to become Krishna conscious means achyuta gotra. Achyuta gotra. Gotra, perhaps you do not know, gotra is the family tradition. In according to Vedic civilization, everybody has got gotra. Gotra means of the same family, of the rishis, gotra from the rishis. So we have to become achyuta gotra, again belonging to the family of Krishna. Now we are fallen, therefore we have forgotten that we belong to the family of Krishna. When we revive our consciousness, Krishna consciousness, that I belong to the Krishna's family. Krishna is not alone. Eka bahushyama. He wants to enjoy. So we are family members of Krishna, not void. That is another aspect. Why Krishna should be alone? He's so powerful, he's so opulent. Have you got any experience that a powerful person, opulent person is alone? Where is that example? Any rich man, any powerful man, any king, any lord, oh, he has got so many associates. So how Krishna can be alone? Krishna is never alone. Therefore, you'll find always Krishna with the gopis, Krishna is the cowherd's boy, Krishna is Arjuna, Krishna is never alone. So these are the condition of becoming achyuta. So Arjuna knows all these things because he's a devotee. Therefore, particularly he's addressing Krishna. Srinaya Rubhayan Madhya Ratha.